Okay, let's do a quick demo. Remember we played around on Telnet in Unit 1 to manipulate web servers directly? I'm going to go ahead and do that here, and we can look at some more HTTP headers. So fire the Telnet to google.com, you know, port 80, as we've been doing. So we do our HTTP request to get the front page. Remember our host header. We see our results. We scroll up to the top of this. We can see our header. So here's the request I made. And here are the headers. And here are a couple set cookie headers. So in this one, this sets a cookie named pref to this value. And it's actually Google's doing a very typical Google thing and storing multiple pieces of data in one cookie. So this is the equal sign that's part of the cookie header. And this equal sign is actually part of the cookie value. This is the end of the cookie value here. We've got a semicolon, and then we have some extra parameters that we haven't talked about yet. We have an expires time, and this is when the cookie expires. So after this date, April 19th, 2014, this cookie will no longer be sent. And this cookie is relevant to the path slash. So you can restrict cookies to specific paths. And this cookie is specific to google.com. And so this basically means that anybody on google.com will receive this cookie. Here is another cookie. This one's called NID. And you can see the value comes all the way down here to the first semicolon. Expires time of its own, a path, a domain, some extra constraints. This cookie is only relevant to HTTP, which is just another cookie option you have at your disposal. I want to show you one quick thing while we're in the terminal here. If you're on Mac or Linux, you can use the curl command, which is pretty cool. Say curl-i, which basically says, get me the headers. curl-i, google.com, and that'll just run the headers. I'm not going to quiz you on that, but if you're on a Unix machine, you can use curl instead of telnet, and you don't have to type so fast and type so much stuff. So anyway, curl-i, handy little tool for viewing HTTP headers. I'll show you one last way to inspect cookies. This may not work for everybody, but it's another neat experiment. Here I am in Chrome. I'm in a special private browsing mode, which is what all this is talking about. Basically, I'm in the private browsing mode because I don't want to have any cookies. And that's generally what these private browsing modes do, is they throw away all of your cookies. So I'm gonna do something here. I've opened up the debug tools in Chrome. These are some developer tools that are built in the Chrome. You can Google around for how to show these in Chrome, or Safari and Internet Explorer also have a similar feature, so you can kind of watch requests. And I'm going to go to google.com, and down here I can see all the requests we made at google.com. And one thing I can do is I can actually view the headers. We can actually view the request header I made for google.com, and you can see we sent some various headers. We didn't send any cookies because we don't have any. And if we scroll down a little bit, we can see one of the cookies that got set right here. This is one of the cookie headers, set cookie. If we were to reload this page, now our browser, Chrome here, has stored this cookie. If we were to reload this page, we should see a new request header. So I'll do that now. I've reloaded the page, and now we can see the request we made to google.com, the request, has a cookie header. And this has the exact same contents as the set cookie, or at least the name here and the value are the same. You don't have to resend path and domain and all those other options. Those are just for the browser to know when to send the cookie. If you're feeling adventurous, you can find a debug mode in your browser and experiment with this sort of stuff. It's kind of neat to see what's there.